For months now, we have been telling you about the nightmare that is Syria. And today, we are dealing with the loss of two fellow journalists. American-born reporter Marie Colvin and French photographer Remi Ochlik were killed today when Syrian troops shelled the house where they were staying. In fact, we have some video of the aftermath of that house. This was in homes. This was being used as a media center for journalists. In fact, our own Arwa Damon recently stayed at that exact home. Marie Colvin was no stranger to war zones. She had been reporting from the front lines for the Sunday Times of London for the past two decades. She lost an eye from a shrapnel wound she suffered in Sri Lanka in 2001, and she appeared here on CNN often. Just last night, in fact, speaking with Anderson Cooper.
Every civilian house on the street has been hit. We're talking about, you know, this is a very kind of poor, popular neighborhood. The top floor of the building I'm in has been hit. In fact, totally destroyed. There are no military targets here.
Again, that was just last night. I want to bring in Peter Bouckaert. He is with Human Rights Watch and has known Colvin for at least 10 years. And he joins me on the phone from Geneva, Switzerland. And Peter, just first, my thoughts, you know, of course, and prayers to her family. And I'm just sorry you lost your friend. And if I may, I just want to begin with this question. You know, what made her tick? I understand this eye patch of hers, this war wound, sort of spoke volumes about her personality.
Well, she was the quintessential war correspondent, a legend. Among her fellows, she was always the first one to show up long before anybody else would arrive. And she really had a passion to report from these difficult places. And for Mary, reporting from war zones was not just about calling a few people over the phone and writing a story. It really was being there with them, understanding and sharing their suffering and reporting from the ground.
I understand you told one of my producers she had a choice between this eye patch and a glass eye, and she chose this patch because why?
Well, I think she did look ravishing with her eye patch. It really was very much a part of her character, and it made her stand out in a crowd. You know, whenever I saw her with her eye patch and her notebook, it just put a smile on my face.
I want to read something. This is a statement from the Sunday Times. Mary was an extraordinary figure in the life of the Sunday Times, driven by a passion to cover wars and the belief that what she did mattered. She believed profoundly that reporting could curtail the excesses of brutal regimes and make the international community take notice. I know you, Peter, have written that Colvin was very anxious to get her latest story out of Syria about this child dying right in front of her. But it was on this website, one of those websites where you have to pay to actually read the story, the content, and that frustrated her. What did she say to you about that?
She contacted me yesterday and she said, please post my story, get over the paywall, and I will face the firing squad tomorrow at the paper. And then she said, I don't often do this, but it is sickening what is happening here. So we posted the story on a private Facebook page for journalists, and another journalist commented and said that he was relieved that she had already left homes. So her response, her last message to us, said, I think the reports of my survival may be exaggerated. I'm in Babo Amr. It's sickening trying to understand how the world can stand by, and I should be hardened by now. I watched a baby die today. Shrapnel, the doctors could do nothing. His little tummy just heaved and heaved until it stopped. I'm feeling helpless as well as cold. I will try to keep getting out the information.
I should be hardened by now, she says. She, as you mentioned, she's a quintessential war journalist and reporter. Obviously, she knew this was a war zone. She knew it going in. She told Anderson last night that of all the conflicts she's covered in her years, that Syria was the worst she had ever seen.